Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at today's stock market for Thursday, September 25th, 2014. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are flat. Gold's down another $9 in the pre-market this morning. So we're certainly not seeing any follow-through from yesterday's big headline number that the Dow is up 154 points as stocks end a three-day slide. It doesn't look to me like something new is starting here. I have to say confidence is low. We can quickly go through the volume leaders that we looked at on Tuesday and Wednesday and just see what kind of impact yesterday's big headline number had on individual stocks. Let's quickly scan through the list of the stocks featured in our volume leaders video on Wednesday for the New York Stock Exchange. In fact, we can do the top 20 volume leaders from that day. Starting off with Bank of America, we drove up to the previous high and stopped. I don't need to name the stocks. We're really looking at the right-hand side here, looking for trend changes, reasons to take action on Thursday morning. And if yesterday was such a huge day, then we should have some. Oh, there's General Electric. New sell signal for General Electric from yesterday's big update in the Dow. Continuing on here, any trend changes? Looks like we're expecting more weakness for Wells Fargo going forward, but no trend change. And then we can start looking at stocks that we didn't feature in the presentation. So AT&T, inside day for Alcoa, inside day yesterday for Advanced Micro Devices. Looks like we're expecting weakness in Sprint. Inside day for Carnival. I'm just going to keep going here. Kinder Morgan looks like it's on the verge of a new buy signal. So a close above yesterday's high, a close above 38.44 would generate a buy signal on Thursday. Citigroup, no change there. Alpha Natural Resources, new low yesterday. There's JP Morgan having a good day. So it looks like most of the financials did well. Peabody Energy, new low for that stock yesterday. And then we're back to Bank of America. So let's do the same thing with the NASDAQ most actives. Now we're looking at the top 10 stocks that we featured in the Tuesday video for the NASDAQ most actively traded stocks. And again, we're looking for trend changes here, reason to take action on Thursday morning. And there is a buy signal here from Micron, certainly not something I would take. This has been a very sloppy stock, and I would certainly wait until there was a more significant sell-off before I'd be interested in buying this stock. Continuing on here, no trend change, no trend change, no trend change, no trend change. We're looking at stocks that were not in Tuesday's presentation now that were on the most actives list. There's BlackBerry, second day of a sell signal for BlackBerry on the U.S. market. Plug Power, no change there. Gilead, there's a new buy signal there for that stock, and so you're looking for a move up to retest the recent high. Groupon, no change there, no change for American Airlines. So a couple of buy signals in the NASDAQ and a new sell signal for General Electric on the New York Stock Exchange. So I didn't see a lot of evidence from those most active charts that the market had really turned around yesterday, and we're still dealing with the same resistance levels that we've been worried about for a while now. We couldn't get the Qs back over 100. We couldn't get the S&P 500 over 2,000. So yes, we have some new buy signals on some stocks and some indexes, ETFs, but I have no interest in taking new bullish trades here at this time. Let's get back to our regularly scheduled program and take a look at our daily index and futures and currency charts. No trend change for the bonds from Wednesday's trading action or in currencies, the US dollar, euro, Japanese yen, Canadian dollar. No change in trend there. We saw the VIX come down hard yesterday, but we're still in the middle of the channel. A close below 1262 is what's needed to give us a sell signal on Thursday. Not expecting to see that. The global Dow had a nice reversal day yesterday. Didn't take out the previous day's high. The Dow 30 certainly did. And, you know, if I could spend my whole day not looking at the Dow or thinking about it, I would. The Dow 30 is what the public follows. It's what the media follows, but it's not what traders follow. They follow the S&P 500. I have no interest in taking this buy signal here, and I would just wave it off and stand aside. If you trade the Dow, the ETFs based on the Dow, then just sit on your hands if you don't want to go long. You certainly don't have to do anything at this time. Looking at the rest of the market, the TSX made a lower low yesterday, came right down to support at the 15,000 level. Low of the day was 15,005. So if we take out 15,000, look for a move down to 14,687.50 for the TSX. Looking at the S&P 500, we traded back into the channel yesterday. The NASDAQ 100 is now just a couple of points above the upper channel line. Again, I'm going to wave this signal off. To really prove that something new is happening here, I want to close above the recent high, and certainly that we didn't get that on Wednesday. Looking at the Russell 2000, made a new low yesterday. A nice reversal, closed near the high of the day, but didn't take out the previous day's high. Neither did the Zacks Microcap, which is trading right down at the July lows. The Venture Exchange was slightly lower yesterday. Looking at financial services, bank stocks were higher yesterday, still in the channel. We saw the Canadian bank stocks continue to move lower on Wednesday. Credit card stocks moved back in the channel on Wednesday, up nearly 1% on the day, but still on a sell signal, no change there. A lower low for U.S. energy stocks, they closed up on the day, didn't take out the previous day's high. Similar situation for the Canadian energy stocks, closed slightly higher on the day, didn't close above the previous day's high. Looking at gold stocks, fairly quiet day there yesterday. Gold's down the pre-market this morning, so we may see a test of this week's lows for both the XAU and the TSX Gold Index. There we've got semiconductors, chip stocks back in the channel, not enough to give us a buy signal. And there's transports, still trading below the lower channel line. They were up on the day yesterday, but not enough to get back in the channel. So we've got the Dow, we've got the NASDAQ 100, both back on buy signals. I personally are going to wave those off and sit on my hands. I do not believe that yesterday was a big turnaround day for the market. Let's move from stocks and take a look at our commodity ETFs. Starting off, looking at the PowerShares Commodity Tracking ETF, we made a new low yesterday and closed up on the day. So up 0.43% on the day, not enough to write home and tell your mom about. We've got copper, a little buying in copper into the open gap yesterday. A little selling in gold and platinum making a new low for this move, and silver making a new low for this move. So no buying in precious metals. Looking at the energy sector, we've got crude oil back on a buy signal here. Now, if you've been playing these buy signals and at any time a symbol is going to disappoint you, you just don't know when it's going to do it. So we've had a series of lower highs and lower lows. And so the trade is still on the short side for crude oil. Crude oil hasn't made any higher highs, so we have no evidence that there's a real change in trend here. If you really want to own crude oil, then what you need to do is stand back and give it a little more breathing room and use something like the midterm chart to give you some guidance. And we need to close on Thursday above 35.70 to give us a buy signal using the midterm chart. Also, you know, you can look at the moving averages, you can look at the flypaper channel and see when a breakout is going to happen. Obviously, on the flypaper channel, we're looking for a huge move up to break out above the flypaper channel. For the moving averages, you can see that the crossover of the 100 and the 200-day moving average is just above $36. That's a point in which a lot of people will be attracted to crude oil. Otherwise, I'd sit on my hands and wait until we saw a buy signal on the midterm chart and just wave off this buy signal, because obviously the market is pretty fickle. You can see all the red and blue dots that we've had over the past few weeks. And there's the same number on the midterm chart telling us that this market is really fickle. Looking at gasoline, still on a buy signal, no change, just closing slightly above the upper channel line yesterday. And there's natural gas, again, trading back in the channel, no change in trend there. And again, for natural gas, we're waiting for a breakout above the August high before we become buyers again. Let's finish off this morning's presentation with a quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. Starting with the VIX, we're looking for an hourly close above 1420 to give us a new buy signal, intraday buy signal for the VIX on Thursday. For the S&P 500, we're currently on an intraday buy signal. A close below 1988.79 would be the first sign that something new is happening for the S&P 500. 4066.71 for the NASDAQ 100, and for the TSX, we're looking for an hourly close below 15,079 to give us a new intraday sell signal for the TSX. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation, and that's all for me for this week. Next time you'll hear my voice is on Tuesday morning. We'll take a look at the NASDAQ most active and today's stock market. So have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again next Tuesday.